Yes, Sairam students. Yes. Now you all coming back to our max topic, max subject. Now you all must be very thorough with the Indian and the international number system. For last few days we have been doing this, that is grouping the numbers, writing the number numerals according to the Indian and the international number system. Now hope you all must have done your home assignment given to you. Yes. Because unless and until you practice, it is not possible for you to understand the concept. So you have to practice all the assignments given and all the sums. Now you all know how to write the numbers in Indian as well as international number system. Today we'll be doing a new topic on comparison and ordering of numbers. Now why do you need to compare two numbers? That is, when two numbers are given, how do you compare? How will you come to know which is the greater one? The first thing is, in max to compare, what do you mean by compare? To compare means to examine the differences between numbers, quantities or values to decide if it is greater than, smaller than or equal to. Now suppose if I take two numbers, that is 9 and 6. If I give you two numbers, let us say if I tell you, or let us take a two digit number. If I say 98 and 66, how will you compare these two numbers? How will you come to know that which one is a greater than or a which one is a greater number or a smaller number, or is it equal to? So comparison is nothing but it means to examine the differences between the numbers to decide if it is greater than, smaller than or equal to than the other quantity, another quantity. Now here we are comparing numbers by comparing we can define or find out that how much a number is greater or smaller. Now in these two numbers you can see 98 and 66. It is always said that the number which comes later on or afterwards is always greater. Okay, the number which comes later on or afterwards is always greater. Now this is regarding two digit number. Now how will you compare? In this chapter we are going to learn how to compare numbers. Two small numbers you can easily compare it, but to compare a larger number, suppose a 8 digit or a 7 digit number, how to compare numbers? So let us learn about this. Now before comparing numbers, before comparing any two numbers, we should always remember the following points. The first point is that a number which has more digits is greater. Now a number which has more digits means what? That is, suppose if I write a number 3, 9, 4, 2, and on the other side I write the number as 4, 1, 3. Now this is one set of number and this is another set of number. Now, from these two numbers, this set of number has got 4 digits and this set of number has got 3 digits. Now how to compare? So always remember the first point, that is, a number which has got more digits is always greater than the other number. So a number which has more digits is always greater than the other number. Now here for example you can see, here you can see the example, that is, here one number, another number, 29,432 and 9,807. This side, that is to your right side, you have a 4 digit number and to your left side you have a 5 digit number. So 29,432 is greater than 9,807. So always a number which has got more digits is always greater than the other. Now the second point what you have to remember is, when two numbers have the same number of digits, like suppose both the sides 5, 5, if a number has got same number of digits, start comparing from the extreme left, that is the highest place value, and then move right to the smaller place values. Now suppose let us take an example, a number, here the number is 2 4, 5, 5, 6, 2. And the other number is 2, 4, 5, 5, 8, 5. Now these are the two sets of numbers. The first number you have, that is, how will you read this according to the Indian system? You will read it as 2,45,562. Here you will read it as 2,45,585. Now see this here, the number in the, you will start from the extreme left side. Okay, but while in the putting the commas according to the Indian and international system, we used to put commas from starting from the right side. But while comparing the numbers, we have to compare when if the number has got the same digits, we will start from the extreme left. Now see here, when you start from the extreme left, that is the number 2 is in lakhs place. In the lakhs place, both the numbers are same. That is 2. I'll just write the place where you ones, tens, 100, 1000, 10,000 and then lakh. Now the number in the 10,000 place is also same. That is 4. The number in the thousands place is also same. That is 5. The number in the hundreds place is also 5. But whereas the number in the tens place is 6 and 8. So here 6 is smaller than 8, or you can say 8 is bigger than or greater than 6. So when you compare these two numbers, the digits in the tens place, that is 6 tens and 8 tens. So 6 tens is smaller than 8 tens, or in other words, you can say 8 tens is greater than 6 tens. So that means this number is greater than the other number. Okay, so when any digits, okay, has got, see, any two numbers having the same number of digits, start comparing from the extreme left, that is from the highest place value. That is, here the number in the lakhs place is 2, then 10 lakhs it is 4, then 10,000s place, 10,000s place it is 2, 10,000s place it is 4, 1000s place it is 5, 100s place it is 5. But whereas in the tens place, it is 6 and 8. So, 6 is smaller than 8, or you can say 8 is greater than 6. So, this number is greater than the other number. Now, let us take one more example. Okay, before that, you also know this is when we start comparing the numbers from the extreme left place. Now you can also compare the numbers by a shortcut method. Now what is a shortcut method? Here what you have to do is you have to make a table. Now when you make a table, write the one number in one box and the other in the other. That is, make a table. One number you will write it here and the other you will write it here. Now, go on seeing the numbers from the extreme left. Now, in this place, when you start from the highest place value, the number 2 is same. So, what you do is, you put a tick. Then, again, here, after that, that is from the lakhs to 10,000s place, the number is again same, that is 4. So, again, put a tick. In the thousands place also, it is, the number is same. So, again, put a tick. In the hundreds place, also the number is same, so you put a tick. Now, when you come to the tens place, the number is 6 and here the number is 8. So, you put a cross. Now, why do you put a cross? You put a cross, that means in the tens place, the number is different. So, you compare that two numbers, 6 and 8. Your 6 is less than 8. 6 is less than 8. So that means your first number, that is 2, 4, 5562 is less than 245585. So understood how to compare using a shortcut method? That is, you will draw a table, put the numbers in that particular table according to the place value chart, or no need to write the place value, you can just write the numbers just as shown in this box, then start comparing the numbers from the extreme left. Now once you start comparing, if the digits are same, just go on putting a tick at the top, and at the place where you get a different digit, you will put a cross. Now when you put a cross, you come to know that the number is different. Then compare that numbers. When you compare that numbers, you'll come to know that which number is greater or smaller than the other. Let us take one more example of an 8-digit number. Here the number is 6,23,73,478, and the other number is 6,23,73,748. Now let us see how to compare using a shortcut method. Now here, as shown, you will draw the box, you'll place the number in one particular block, then start comparing the numbers from the extreme left. Now the number is in the highest place value, that is crore place. The number both 6 and 6 is same, so you will put a tick. Again the number in the lakhs place, it is 2, that is 10 lakhs place, it is 2, so you will put a tick. Again 3 in the lakhs place is also same, so you will put a tick. 7 in 10,000s place, it is same for both the numbers, so you'll put a tick. 3 in the thousands place, again it is the same number, so you'll put a tick. Now see the number in the hundreds place, it is 4 and 7, so you will put a cross on that particular box on top. Here the 4 is smaller than 7. That means the first number, that is 6,23,73,478, is smaller than the other number. Or in other words, you can say 6,23,73,748 is greater than the other number. So I think this is very easy for you to understand, that is using a shortcut method, how you put that is okay. Now let us do some exercise sums based on this. The first is, here some numbers are given to you. Compare the pair of numbers given below. Compare the pair of numbers given below. Now see the first one, A1. Already both the sides, it is a 5-digit number. The first number is 25,434 and the second number is 52,434. Now see the number at the first place, that is 2 and 5. That is 5 is greater than 2. That means the second number is greater than the first. So you will put a this sign, greater side towards the 5. Now you know how to put a greater sign, correct? That is a crocodile face. You all must have learned in the your lower class, that is third and fourth standard, how to put the greater sign. So 2 is smaller than 5, so your this number, first number is greater, second number is greater than the first one. Okay, now coming to the next sum, B sum. Okay, B is both the sides, first number is a 6-digit number and the second number is a 5-digit number. So obviously, while starting the chapter, I have already told you, a number which has got a more number of digits is always greater. Now here it is a 6-digit number, here it is a 5-digit number. So obviously, the first number is greater than the second. Okay, now coming to the C1. Now see the number 5 lakh 36,785, and the other number is 5,38,785. The first number is 5,36,785, and the next number is 5,38,000. Just place the commas. 785. Now here we will use the shortcut method which I already taught you. The first in the lakhs place, the number 5 is same. Okay, again in the 10,000s place, the number 3 is same. Coming to the thousands place, 6 and 8. Now 6 is smaller than 8. Now 6 is smaller than 8. That means the first number is smaller than the second number. So here you will put the sign as first number is smaller, so you will put this sign. Okay, now coming to the D sum, how will you read? The first number is a 7 digit number, correct? Second number is a 8 digit number, 8 digit number. So obviously according to the first point, the number which has got more digits is always greater. So are you all understanding? Yes. Now coming to the E sum, again here 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 digit number here, and here you have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 digit number. Correct? You can just count the number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and here 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So obviously this number has got more digits, so this is greater than the second number. That means the first number is greater than the second number. Coming to the last sum, here 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 digit number, and here 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 digit number. This number is a 7 digit number and this is a 8 digit number. So obviously according to the first rule, a number which has got more digits is greater. So this number is greater than the other first number. Now I think hope you all must have understood this, like how to compare two numbers. Coming to the next sum, see here. Second sum is, in an auto expo in Bangalore, some new cars were showcased. Their prices are mentioned below. Now the price of every car is mentioned there. You can just read the price of the car. The first car, that is A, it is 13,05,382. The second car is 2,03,45,500. Car C, the price of car C is 89,32,000. And the price of car D is 4,45,89,414. Now again, here you have to compare the prices of the cars. Now the first one, car A, the price of the car A is, you can see here, the price, what is the price of the car A? That is 13,05,382. And what is the price of car C? It is 89,32,000. Okay. Now here, 1 is smaller than 8. 1 is smaller than 8. So obviously the price of car C is more than the price of car A. Okay, coming to the second sum, car D. Price of car D. What is the price of car D? It is 4,45,89,414. Whereas the price of car B is 2 crore. So obviously 2 is smaller than 4. So that means the price of car D is more. So you will put a greater sign in the car D. Again car C and car B. Car C is 89,32,000. whereas car B is 2 crores. So that means car B is, price of car B is greater than the price of car C. And coming to the last one, car D and car A. Now price of car D is 4 crore. Yes. And the price of car A is 13 lakhs. So obviously the price of car D is more or greater than the price of car A. Yes. Now in this, which is the most expensive car? Which is the expensive car? Now, car A 13 lakhs, car B is 2 crore, car C is 89 lakhs, and car D obviously it is cost 4 crores. So the expensive car is which one? That is car D. Here you write it as car D. Now which car is least expensive? Least expensive means which is low in price. Yes. Now car D is 4 crore, car C is 89 lakh, B is 2 crore, and the price of car A is 13 lakhs. So which is least expensive? Which is less? Which car is very less in price? That is car B. So which is least expensive is car A. I hope you all must have understood this exercise. Yes. Now here is some home assignment for you. Now you all have studied how to compare two big numbers or two large numbers. Okay. Now first go from the extreme left, which I already done. Now according to the shortcut method also I have taught you. So now here are some three sums given to you. You have to find the greatest number. Okay, so this home assignment has to be done so that you be thorough with how to find the greatest number. Okay, students, thank you.